Hello and welcome to the Cleveland Museum of Art. My name is JP Peralta and I'm a gallery teacher at the Art Museum. Today I'm going to be looking at an object called the Eleven-Headed Guanyin. Guanyin is a bodhisattva, which in Buddhism is just somebody who has reached enlightenment but has delayed actually attaining it in order to help those of us who are still suffering on earth. And Guanyin actually has little urna in the center of his head, which is a third eye that doesn't see physical, material things, rather it can just see human suffering, so it can get where he needs to be. The Guanyin also has 11 heads because each head represents one step on the path to enlightenment, though this object's from 960 AD, so it's over 1,000 years old, and a lot of those heads have lost detail. It's just what happens when something is that old. There are some questions we can ask about every object to be able to make some educated guesses about it, even if we don't know anything about the object beforehand. Those questions are, what is it made of, and how big is it? When we answer these questions, we can maybe make some guesses about the object. Now, this object is made of wood, with gold polychromy. And you can look at any of the damaged areas and you can see wood grain. You can tell that it's made of wood if you look closely. But it's not made of stone or metal, so not really rich materials, but it still has gold on it. So it's still of some importance. Similarly, this object is about life size. So it's not like a prayer knot, like something you could carry around with you, but it's also not carved into a mountainside. However, it's still something that people could go to for devotion. So we can maybe not know specifically where this object was, but we can kind of say with some degree of confidence that this was a relatively important devotional object that people had to go to. So maybe it was inside of a temple or something. One of my favorite things to do with this object is to imagine what the arms were doing. And we can never know for certain what the arms are doing unless we find the arms, but we can make some guesses, but my favorite thing to do is to take the pose of the object, stand exactly like it, see if you can make the same face, it's kind of sultry, and see what your arms do. Is it doing two thumbs up? Is it doing a mudra that you might know? I can't say for certain, but I think it's one of my favorite things to do with this object and with students, so give it a shot and see what you can come up with. I want to thank you for joining me on this close looking at the 11-headed Guanyin. I hope you can come to the museum and visit in person. Just make sure you reserve your tickets ahead of time, and of course, you gotta wear your mask. Until next time, take care.